my name is Heather Wilson, and I'm the Midwest Save Our Streams Coordinator with the Izaak, Walton League of America. Factory pollution in water is a pervasive problem across the United States, with harmful effects on the environment and human health. Unfortunately, Americans in general have a poor understanding of this pollution problem, including how widespread it is and its impacts. Our new community science initiative, called Nitrate Watch, is here to help. First, what is nitrate pollution? Nitrate is a naturally occurring compound made up of nitrogen and oxygen. Nitrogen is an essential nutrient for plants. It's found in enzymes and proteins, and it's a key component of chlorophyll molecules. Unfortunately, humans apply more nitrogen to the landscape than plants and soils can absorb. Sources of excess nitrate include fertilizers, manure from animal feedlots, wastewater treatment, and atmospheric deposition. As nitrogen moves to the environment, it interacts with nitrifying bacteria and becomes nitrate. Nitrate is soluble in water, which means that it's easily carried off the land by rainwater, irrigation systems, or melting snow. Through surface runoff or groundwater saturation, nitrate frequently makes its way into streams, lakes, and our sources of drinking water. This is where problems arise. Nitrate pollution has negative impacts on human health, the environment, and the economy. When we consume too much nitrate, it can make it harder for our blood to transport oxygen. In infants younger than 6 months, that can lead to a condition called methemoglobinemia, or blue baby syndrome, which can cause the skin to turn bluish-gray and may lead to serious illness or death. Research has shown that other health conditions are also linked to consuming high levels of nitrate. Peer-reviewed studies document increased risk of colon cancer, thyroid disease, and neural tube birth defects in populations with prolonged exposure to drinking water contaminated with nitrate. Even more concerning, these health effects have been observed when nitrate levels in drinking water are lower than the current federal drinking water standards allow. When waterways receive an influx of nitrate pollution, a cascade of ecological effects is set in motion. First, the increased available nitrogen is taken up by aquatic plants, especially algae, creating what is known as an algae bloom. This not only encourages the formation of unsightly scum on the water, but also makes it difficult for aquatic plants and animals to survive. Algae blooms block out sunlight, lowering the water column, increase water temperature, and deplete dissolved oxygen. This can result in fish kills and the formation of dead zones. Algae blooms also threaten human health. In some cases, algae blooms harbor toxic cyanobacteria, also called blue-green algae. These cyanobacteria create compounds called cyanotoxins, which can be dangerous and even deadly to humans or animals that come into contact with them. When beaches and waterways are closed to swimming in the summer, cyanotoxins from harmful algae blooms are often to blame. Beyond the obvious value of human health and environmental quality, nitrate pollution is very costly. Nitrate pollution has far-reaching effects on the economy, impacting a wide range of industries. From the cost of nitrate removal infrastructure to keep drinking water safe, to the costs associated with treating nitrate-related health issues, to lost revenue in the recreation and commercial fishing industries, to declining value of waterfront property, the cost of nitrate pollution adds up. Altogether, the estimated impact of nitrate pollution on the U.S. economy is approximately $210 billion a year. So, what can we do? This is where Nitrate Watch comes in. The Izaak Walton League is excited to launch this new community science initiative that invites volunteers across the country to monitor nitrate levels in the water bodies that are important to them and empowers them to communicate about their results. Volunteers are able to sample surface water, like rivers, lakes, and streams, as well as drinking water from public water systems or private groundwater wells. The goals of Nitrate Watch are to raise awareness about the impacts of nitrate on the environment and human health, identify hotspots of nitrate pollution, and advocate for solutions that reduce nutrient pollution. Joining Nitrate Watch is easy. Simply visit our website, www.nitratewatch.org, to take the Nitrate Watch pledge and request a free Nitrate Watch kit. Your kit will be mailed to you along with all the information you'll need to use your nitrate test strips and share your results. Sampling is easy to do and takes less than 1 minute to complete. Each kit contains 25 nitrate test strips, allowing volunteers to document nitrate levels in their water sources over an extended period of time. We encourage volunteers to make a plan to use each and every one of the test strips included in their kit. Each kit also includes a Nitrate Watch sticker and postcards that will explain how to use your test strips and report your data. Nitrate Watch data is shared on the Clean Water Hub National Water Quality Database, where it can be easily accessed and understood by volunteers and the general public. The Clean Water Hub makes it easy to explore data and visualize trends with interactive maps and color-coded graphs. Education is a key component of Nitrate Watch, and we've created resources to help our volunteers educate themselves and others about this pollution problem. At nitratewatch.org, volunteers can find answers to frequently asked questions about nitrate pollution and Nitrate Watch, as well as blog posts that explore different facets of this issue. Volunteers can use the Make a Plan worksheet to create a strategy to use all of the test strips provided in their Nitrate Watch kit. This worksheet helps volunteers plan out where to use their test strips, how often they want to monitor, and who to contact if they measure unsafe levels of nitrate. We've also created resources that make it easy for volunteers to advocate for solutions that will curb the effects of nitrate pollution. Volunteers are encouraged to sign the Nitrate Watch petition and urge community leaders to take action to reduce nitrate pollution. We've created templates for letters to the editor and letters to representatives, which volunteers can share with local media and elected officials calling for action at a local level. Informational fact sheets are also available for volunteers who want to spread the word about the impacts of nitrate pollution with other community members. All of these resources can be found at nitratewatch.org on the What You Can Do page. Want to help other clean water advocates take part in Nitrate Watch? Pay it forward and sponsor a kit. The number of kits we're able to disperse is directly linked to our available funds. The generosity of our sponsors helps us reach more communities, gather more data, and make a bigger splash. Visit iwla.org/nitratesponsor to contribute to this program. Are you ready to join the Nitrate Watch? To request a kit and find educational and advocacy resources, visit our website at www.nitratewatch.org. For questions or to inquire about partnership opportunities, shoot us an email at nitratewatch@iwla.org. We hope you enjoyed learning more about this new program, and we can't wait to welcome you into the Nitrate Watch community.